Welcome to a lesson in which we'll be given several intervals expressed using interval notation and then asked to graph the interval and express the interval using an inequality. So looking at our first interval here, we have the interval from negative 2 to positive infinity, but because of this square bracket here, this indicates that negative 2 is in the interval where the interval is closed on negative 2. So to graph this, we make a closed point on negative 2 to indicate negative 2 is in the interval, and then approaching positive infinity means we'll graph to the right, again approaching positive infinity. And so now to express this using an inequality, we would say x is greater than or equal to negative 2. Again, greater than because we're graphing to the right, and equal to because negative 2 is included in the interval, or because of the closed point, or using interval notation because of the square bracket. Looking at the second example, we have the interval from negative 2 to negative infinity. Notice how it does not include negative 2, and we know this because of the rounded parenthesis. So to graph this, we make an open point on negative 2, and then because we're approaching negative infinity, we graph to the left. So using an inequality, we can say that x is less than negative 2. Notice how we did not say less than or equal to because negative 2 is not included in the interval. Now let's take a look at two compound inequalities. Here we have the interval from negative 3 to positive 4, where negative 3 is included because of the square bracket and positive 4 is not included because of the rounded parenthesis. So to graph this, we'd make it a closed point on negative 3 because it's included in the interval. We'd make an open point on positive 4 and then graph all the real numbers between these from negative 3 to positive 4. And now let's write this as an inequality. This is actually the intersection of two inequalities, so we'll have two inequalities connected with and. We can say x is greater than or equal to negative 3 and x also has to be less than 4. These both have to be true to define this interval. Because this is an and, or the intersection of two inequalities, we can also write this a different way, where if we put x in the middle and write this inequality in the opposite direction, we can say x is greater than or equal to negative 3 and x is less than 4. So because this is an and compound inequality, we can also write it like this, and we can also say negative 3 less than or equal to x and x is less than 4. These are both equivalent, just written a different way. And now for the last example, here we have the interval from negative 3 to negative infinity, where because of the bracket it includes negative 3. So let's go ahead and graph this part first. Close point on negative 3, approaching negative infinity, so we graph to the left. This U here means union. We can also say or, the interval from 4 to infinity, where because of this rounded parenthesis, 4 is not included in the interval, so we make an open point on 4, and we graph to the right, approaching positive infinity. And now for the inequality, we'll have x is less than or equal to negative 3, or x is greater than positive 4. We use the word or to indicate that if x is in either of these intervals, it would fall into the graphed interval. Okay, that's going to do it for these examples. I hope you found this helpful.